We're hitting the open road to decarbonization, traveling across the U.S. to visit Better Climate Challenge partner plants and buildings to highlight their innovative solutions to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. Our first stop, Nashville, Tennessee. Man, I can't believe we're eating barbecue for breakfast.
When in Nashville, we have to do it right. I love everything about Nashville. Good music, good food, and we may end up dancing, John.
Well, before we do that, we got some business to take care of today.
Oh, yes. I wonder where Maria is sending us today.
Why don't we find out?
Hi, John and Sachin. Today, you'll be traveling to the Chemours facility in New Johnsonville, just outside Nashville. I want you to dig in into how Chemours is delivering responsible chemistry and doing it with a smaller carbon footprint. So do your thing, geek out, and give me the full report on all their decarbonization efforts.
Awesome. Chemours, as a chemical engineer, this one's gonna be fun for me.
Oh yes, and I love chemistry.
Let's get this food to go and get on the road.
Let's do it.
Hello, welcome to Chemours Johnsonville.
Hi.
Brian.
Nice to meet you, Brian. Sachin.
Nice to meet you both.
So Brian, can you tell me a little more about Chemours?
Sure. This facility will make top-pure titanium dioxide, commonly known as TiO2. Titanium dioxide is a product which provides our customers a superior opacity and a bright white color so that they can use those in their paints and plastics, laminates, and paper. We have goals specific to greenhouse gas emissions. By 2050, we want to be net zero greenhouse gas emitter. By 2030, we'd like to see a 60% reduction. We've also signed an agreement for 32,000 megawatts per year of electricity from solar energy. That project represents 19% of our site consumption. Last update was we had met and achieved 18% reduction since our baseline in 2018.
That's terrific. Great progress.
That's really good progress.
Today is the combustion turbine unit that provides the Chemours New Johnsonville site steam. It is a nameplate capacity unit of 600,000 pounds per hour steam.
Wow.
Steam is pipeline conveyed from here over to our manufacturing process to make titanium dioxide. With coal being on the way out, we worked with a partnership to have this combustion turbine unit with the heat recovery system use natural gas to provide us steam. This is the turbine unit with the heat recovery steam generator on it, and the heat recovery steam generator really functions to capture all that waste heat that would otherwise just be lost.
This is our river water pump site that we supply all the water to the plant. We basically have six peerless pumps that can put out 12,000 gallons a minute. Most of the time we're running four to five pumps and we run about 45,000 gallons of water a minute. We have to run a backflow preventer valve to hold pressure on the bearings. It has to run from 80 to 120 PSI. At that rate, we're not able to get the full flow out of our river water pumps. We're looking at changing the impeller design that will actually put a lift on the bearings of the motor. And that way we can go from 9,000 gallons a minute, 12,000 gallons a minute, cut out at least one, maybe two river water pumps. Being able to get 3,000 gallons more out of a river water pump and being able to shut one down is the biggest thing.
That's impressive. So fewer pumps means less energy used.
Right.
Would that also enable you to do something else, like perhaps a VFD?
With this design, we may have to have maybe one or two VFDs because we have to maintain 80 pounds of pressure on our header. Because of the age of our plant, we really can't exceed that. So our biggest thing, we have to control our header pressure.
When we were talking with Joe about the water pumps, that's really cool to see how they're then taking a creative solution with the impeller design so that then they can reduce the use of those pumps and maybe even introduce a VFD.
I think definitely it will help them with this ambitious goal, like 60% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions by 2030.
The chemical sector is one of the hardest to decarbonize, but there's a lot of progress being made so far and a lot more coming up.
This is the team manager's office for the oxidation and purification area of the plant here for making TiO2.
We heard you're actually collecting a lot of data like temperature, flow, pressure. How are you actually using that data to come up with energy efficiency opportunities or decarbonization opportunities?
We have big data that collects all the attributes that go into and looking at our production rates, our operating conditions, and it will calculate how much natural gas we should be using on our burners. It will tell us if we're using the right amount or too much natural gas, and we'll take corrective actions if we find that we're using too much natural gas. We have some automatic controls for like our fuel to air ratios are automatically controlled to minimize any excess energy that has to go into our process. But we are looking at ways, can we get by without using steam for certain parts of the process and use either alternative forms of heating or use some different form in the process that doesn't require the steam at all. If we can find a way to bypass that system completely, all of a sudden our energy cost and our CO2 emissions from that go to zero.
That was a lot of fun.
We learned so much about responsible chemistry, smart chemistry.
A lot of great examples of Chemours reducing their emissions and improving their energy efficiency. I'm excited to see where we get sent next.
Maria, keep sending us to exciting places.